Hello and welcome to Wisdom Trek. This is Guthrie Chamberlain, and I'm your guide to wisdom and creating a living legacy. Thank you for joining us on our 7 day a week, 7 minutes of wisdom podcast. This is day 82 of our trek, and now that we know and understand that we need to become comfortable with being uncomfortable, we will expand this concept so that your legacy building will be strengthened and enhanced. We are recording our podcast from our studios at Home 2 in Charlotte, North Carolina, and today finds us making some preparations and finishing up details here as we will be heading back to Marietta and the Big House on Saturday for another 3 week stay. In addition to more renovating work that I hope to complete while we are there, we have several other activities planned. We have a nephew that is getting ordained on Sunday in Lancaster, Ohio. Tuesday is our 36th wedding anniversary, and we have several relaxing day trips planned for that week. That Saturday will be my 59th birthday. Also, I will be speaking at the church that we used to attend in Marietta on the Sundays of September 6th and 13th. And one last thing is the annual Sternwell Festival is held on the weekend of September 12th. The fireworks displays they have every year at the festival is the best that we've ever seen, and it draws a lot of people into our small town. It's quite magical. It will be a busy and enjoyable 3 weeks, and we are really looking forward to it. As we begin our journey today, we want to continue on the same trail that we started yesterday, but venture out of our comfort zone. When we leave our zone of comfort, although it may appear to be intimidating and less secure, most of the time it will prove beneficial for us on our long-term growth because outside our comfort zone is where the magic happens. When we force ourselves outside this comfort zone, it allows us to stretch and grow and to become all that God has destined us to be. There are actually three zones where we can live, but only one of those zones are optimal for life in that we will have the most productive impact, which will allow you to flourish and grow. So let's explore these three zones of our life in detail. The first one is our comfort zone. Your comfort zone is a psychological place where you feel safe and in control. You experience low anxiety, and you're using a limited set of behaviors. This means that you're not growing or developing any new skills. Essentially, you're stuck on autopilot. You're just going through the motions. Clearly, it is not the place that fosters growth. It's in our comfort zone that we feel safe and secure. It is the zone of routine, the place where we do those things that we find safe, comfortable, easy, and familiar. The comfort zone is a place where nothing particularly challenging happens. As I grew up on an apple orchard, I can certainly relate to the quote from Will Rogers, "You've got to go out on the limb sometimes because that is where the fruit is." Scientists have researched the role anxiety plays in our performance. They have found that too little anxiety results in poor performance, while increasing that anxiety causes an increase in performance. But at the other end, extreme or too much anxiety reduces performance once again. The finding from this research shows that if we are to maximize our performance, we need to be in a state of optimal anxiety. If you want to see a visual bell curve example of this, please check out the journal for today's podcast. I have a representation of it within the journal. The optimal level of anxiety, then, is found in our learning zone, just outside the comfort zone, but before heading into the danger zone. Although it's not real evident, there are significant dangers that lurk within the comfort zone. Dennis Waitley put it this way, "Life is inherently risky. There is only one big risk, though, that we should avoid at all costs, and that is the risk of doing nothing." You know you're in your comfort zone when you feel no anxiety, no pressure, and no stress. You're doing things that are easy, comfortable, and familiar. You're in control and doing the things that you know how to. They don't take much physical or emotional energy. It's dangerous to stay in this comfort zone for long periods of time. It leads to mediocrity, stagnation, and lack of growth. If you spend too much time in your comfort zone, you end up bored and unchallenged. So to recap, comfort zone limits your goals and dreams, the comfort zone limits your potential, and the comfort zones encourage mediocrity. The second zone is the learning zone. Daniel H. Pink put it this way, "We need a place of productive discomfort. If you're too comfortable, you're not productive. And if you're too uncomfortable, you're not productive." Sort of like Goldilocks, it can't be too hot or too cold. But the learning zone is where the magic happens. It's the place where you grow, where success is built, and your goals are attained. If you've ever pushed yourself to get to the next level in sport, fitness, or by learning a new skill, you know what it's like to step outside of your comfort zone. You know what it's like to be in the learning zone. It's like going to the gym for the first time. The exercises are difficult and you struggle. They take a lot of energy and concentration to complete. However, each week you grow stronger. The exercises become easier and they require less energy to complete. However, as the exercises become easier, you get less physical benefit from them, and soon you find yourself becoming used to your exercise routine. Your heart rate no longer rises, and you're not sore in the mornings. When this happens, you are no longer growing stronger. You're back in your comfort zone. The solution? You need to change your exercise routine. You need to switch to a new set of exercises, and the same principle holds for other areas of our lives. Brian Tracy said, "Move out of your comfort zone. You can only grow if you are willing to feel awkward and uncomfortable when you try something new. Unless you spend your time in your learning zone, you'll fail to grow. You can go to the gym every day, do the same exercises for months and months without any benefit. If what you're doing is comfortable and easy, you're not in the learning zone. And if you're not in the learning zone, you're not growing." And the third zone is the danger zone. T.S. Eliot said, "Only those who risk going too far can possibly know how far one can go." At the end of the learning zone, you enter the danger zone. This is the place where you start to lose focus again. You begin to panic and performance declines. You need to ensure that you don't push yourself too hard, too quickly, and thereby enter into the danger zone. Going back to our gym example, if you try to lift a weight that is too heavy, you're likely to damage your tendons or tear a muscle. The lesson is to remain in your learning zone and to stay out of the danger zone. You can stay out of the danger zone by taking regular breaks. Place yourself in the learning zone for a period of time, and then retreat back to your comfort zone for a short time to take a break. Once rested, then prepare for the next push into the learning zone. Gradually, spending more time in the learning zone, it will become comfortable, and then you can grow into a new learning zone. The Apostle Paul wrote in his first letter to the Church of Corinth, as he understood the concept of getting out of your comfort zone, when he compared his preparation to that of an athlete in chapter 9, verses 24 through 27. And Paul writes, "Don't you realize that in a race everyone runs, but only one person gets the prize? So run to win. All athletes are disciplined in their training. They do it to win the prize that will fade away, but we do it for an eternal prize. So I run with a purpose in every step. I am not just shadow boxing. I discipline my body like an athlete, training it to do what it should. Otherwise, I fear after preaching to others, I myself might be disqualified." So my exhortation for today is try something new each week. If it doesn't challenge you, it won't change you. So please join our camp tomorrow for another day of Wisdom Trek, Creating a Legacy, where tomorrow we will begin a series on how a wise person understands when not to speak. Well, that will finish our podcast for today. If you've missed any of the previous podcasts, please check out Wisdom Trek on iTunes, Stitcher, SoundCloud, Spreaker, YouTube, or at wisdom-trek.com. If you enjoy our daily doses of wisdom, these little nuggets we consume each day, I encourage you to take the time to invest in yourself in these three ways. Invest with your time in improving Wisdom Trek by leaving your name, email address, and a comment on our website so that we can provide you with the wisdom and insights that best fit your needs. Number two, invest in yourself by listening to your 7 minutes of wisdom through the Wisdom Trek podcast each day. And the best way to do this is to subscribe at iTunes or Stitcher and have it downloaded to you automatically. And third, invest in the lives of others by sharing with your family and friends, in person or online, to journey with us on our Wisdom Trek. And if you haven't done so already, please leave us a rating at iTunes or Stitcher so that we'll gain more exposure for others to join us on our Wisdom Trek. The journal for this podcast can be found at wisdom-trek.com, where we also have pictures, tweetable quotes, wisdom nuggets, and free resources. Thank you for allowing me to be your guide, mentor, but most importantly, your friend, as I serve you through the Wisdom Trek podcast and journal each day. As we take this trek together, let us always live abundantly or fully, love unconditionally, listen intentionally, learn continuously, lend to others generously, lead with integrity, and leave a living legacy each day. This is Guthrie Chamberlain reminding you to keep moving forward, enjoy your journey, and create a great day every day. See you tomorrow.